Oh my gosh, darling, and it was just so much fun. Oh, I couldn't believe how beautiful Jacob's area was. And oh my goodness, oh, I brought home a little tree. I'll have to show you in a little bit. He had a really amazing tree. It even has a name. Oh, where did I put it? I don't have it on me right now. It's inside my bags, and I'm so tired from my big adventure yesterday. It was absolutely fantastic. A busy Saturday as always, but oh my goodness, it's just been great. Oh, and I love you, darling. Oh my goodness, it was really fun. All right, and Tate, Ash, Lily girl. Ah, there you are, Lily girl. Ah, it has been a big journey this week, you three. So let's go ahead and get you over to the doggy pen so that we can bathe you. Because, Tate, I can't believe you jumped right into that campfire yesterday. You are just such a silly boy. Are you sure you don't have any burns on you? I really should start carrying some aloe vera just in case. In fact, that sounds like a good idea, having a puppy first aid kit. Oh, actually, that would be a really good idea. You know what? Maybe we'll put together a puppy first aid kit. In fact, I bet I could talk to the people over at the Three Paw Doggy Daycare. Yes, you guys heard, Three Paw Doggy Daycare. It is that day. Today, it's time to bathe you guys. It's time to go, yes, it's time to go get more food. We'll go get some beef liver chunks and some pig's ears, and we'll go see if James has any other fancy new foods that you guys can enjoy at the daycare. But it is doggy day, so we're gonna come and bathe everybody and see what's hiding inside of your inventories. And we're also going to go pick up Alia and Devin. Alia and Devin from the daycare. Oh my goodness. Oh, and not to mention Ash, come on. Look, I know that you're a little bit nervous, but last time I saw you, buddy, you went on that special walk. I don't know why you decided to go into some catacombs, but you brought back the tiny little grave of a puppy spirit. And then the dryad, she managed to bring you, like, that puppy spirit back to life. And I'm not sure about that. It was a little bit alarming, I'm not gonna lie. I'm used to the, well, actually, I guess I have brought back my villager son several times from their graves and their deaths. But still, Ash, you've seen me with Junior and JJ, my villager sons, that's right. And so you know if you bring back a spirit to life, then it is your responsibility to take care of that spirit. So you have a little puppy son now, and you can't just, oh, Lily, I'm trying to have a stern conversation with your nephew here. So you cannot just run off on your new responsibility of taking care of your puppy. Do you hear me, sir? Do you hear me? Ash? Okay, well, I'm sure fatherhood will come to you eventually. Maybe you can listen to Tate and Pine tell you some tips, okay? All right, well, let's go check on your little puppy and see how he's doing. And Tate, make sure you don't fuss too much with the hedgehog. Oh gosh, thank you, little hedgehog. It's giving me another dandelion seed. Oh, I love my garden. It's just turning out wonderfully. Oh, and Aki, look at this. It looks like you have, oh gosh, and Agent Noodles, you found a feather. Thank you. And you also gave me this spice leaf when I got home and this medium grass. So Agent Noodles, you are really, Lily, where are you going? Oh my goodness. It's bath time, you guys. It's almost bath time. So it looks like Agent Noodles is gathering up feathers and little tufts of grass and spice leaves for me from my garden. He's just rustling around in there for all sorts of things. And it looks like Aki has spread my little pineapple garden quite a bit, which is quite fun. But all right, Ash, Tate, Lily, got you guys. Three out of my many, many dogs. And I have missed my puppies. So because it's a beautiful, beautiful day, let's go ahead and pop in and we're gonna, oh, look, there he is. Come on, Ash. Come on, look, I know you're a little bit nervous about this. It is a big responsibility, but you need to come and take care of your little one. Come on, he's such a cute little guy. Oh gosh, what's this? Ash, your puppy just gave me something. What did you find, little one? This is a really, wow, this is so old. Relic. This is a very old little medallion. I can't believe this. It looks so aged. It's chipped and battered, and it has the name Relic carved into it. Is that your name? Is that your name, little guy? Was this with your grave? I mean, not to bring back bad memories, if that does bring back bad memories, but I guess, is that your name? Ash, where did you get this little one? I'm gonna have to ask Erica where the heck she took you on a walk. Knowing you, you probably ran off and sniffed inside of a catacomb like you weren't supposed to, but all right. Hi, buddy. Relic. What a cool name. All right, Ash, come on inside. I'm gonna give you a bath and make sure you're doing well, and then you come over and hang out with your son. Oh, and look at Puppy the duck. Oh, I love him. Puppy, come here. Come here. We're gonna go ahead and you can stretch your little paws. Feet, I guess, your wings, by walking around some. And then Tate, please stop trying to dig into the water and fish in the stream. There we go. All right, so it is a doggy dog quest day for sure. So let's make sure we give everybody who went with me on all of the adventures a bath. And Relic, Wow, you're a little mystery. I have a feeling we're going to learn a lot more about you and where you came from. And I mean, he just has such an aura of, are you intimidated? Ash, don't hide behind the tree. He is your puppy to take care of now. I wonder if you're a little intimidated by him, but we'll work on that. All right, come here. Here, look, I'm going to give you a bath so you can hang out with your new son. All right. Oh, I guess. Okay, Ash, hang on. I have to actually go and get the things to give you a bath. Pine, Iris, hi, guys. I'm sorry I didn't bring you with me on walks like this week. I promise I'll start taking you guys out on more walks and rotating which dogs come with me more often. All right, and then let me go ahead and put this interesting relic. Now, that's going to be quite... Oh, my gosh. Why do I have... my packs are just full of everything. Just full of everything. I might have to show this... it's really old, so I guess I should probably show this medallion maybe to the archaeologist over at Relic Ruins. I mean, oh, Relic. I wonder if he has something to do with Relic Ruins then. I think I'll go show this to the archaeologist over there and see if it rings any bells for them. Also, when did I get so many emerald coins? I must have snagged these from Martha. Oh my gosh, she's going to be so mad at me. But at least we have the money already so that I can go and buy the dog food I need this week. And speaking of which, Ash, I really think you're overreacting. I know it's a big responsibility to take care of a puppy. Trust me, I have like 8 of you guys. But, well, I guess I do have 8 now that Relic is with us. Look, it's really fun, and that's not even counting Pine and Devin's puppies. It'll be okay, Ash. It will be okay. All right, well, we'll worry about him in just a minute. Let's go ahead and grab the soap, and let's grab the little wash, and then let's grab the wood plank. There we go. And now we can give everybody a proper bath. There. All right. So we'll scrub them down and check what's hiding inside of inventories. We'll move these things over here. There we go. All right, Pine, let's go ahead and give you... Oh, you're playing with your little rope toy. I love it. Let's go ahead and give you a bath first, and Zoe, go ahead and start walking around. Pine, come back. All right, Ash, looks like you're getting the bath first. There we go. Scrub you down with soap, scrub you down with the cotton, and... Oh, wow, you picked up a lot. Peanuts! Ash, I needed those peanuts for Zoo Kitchen so that we'll be able to make some more peanut butter. Good boy, Ash, good boy. And he's off. Lily, as usual, you are being very responsible, and you are ready to be washed and scrubbed down right behind your ears. Oh, how's that? And then we'll go ahead. Wow, look at all of this. This is from when you were definitely helping me to be to clear out those areas for our temperate forest zone, isn't it? Ash, are you checking out what your aunt's up to? Hello, little relic. Man, that's gonna be so interesting. I think what we'll do is we'll take that little medallion. All right, hang on, you guys. Hang on. Stay here. You guys don't need to follow me just yet. I think we'll take the medallion and we will show it to the archaeologist at Relic Ruins at some point. But for today, since it is a very busy day, we're just going to focus on washing the dogs, and then I definitely need to go over and see what's going on at the doggy daycare. Oh, I can't wait to pick up Devin. I have missed Devin, and I bet Pine has missed his mate, and I bet he misses his puppies a lot too. I should see, the puppies are probably old enough, actually, Lily girl. The puppies are probably almost old enough to be able to come home and even start going on adventures with us. Oh, that'll be so fun. All right, come back here, Lily. I'm not done bathing you. All right, we're going to come over. And then, oh, Relic, you've got more of these? Oh, gosh, I really need to take them. So at least I've got multiple little things. They do look like a medallion, though. I swear these things look like a name tag almost. Lily, we need to go to the daycare. Come on, Lily. Oh my gosh. Okay, she's just being silly. Zoe, how did you get out? Oh my goodness, my puppies. My puppies are just all over the place. Zoe, have you picked anything up this week? All right, let's go ahead and see. Gonna give you a bath and scrub you down. I promise I'll start taking you out. Oh, she did pick some things up. I'll start taking you out on more little trips too. Oh, who's a good girl, Zozo? Who's a good girl? All right, Iris, have you managed to pick anything up? All right. I'll have to get you guys some good treats. Scrub you down, wash you down. Some good treats from Relic Ruins. Oh my goodness, you guys have picked up so many fish just from the rain. I don't know any other world where it rains fish, but it definitely does here. All right, Ash, you're doing okay. Lily, oh, Lily, are you playing? She's still playing with the rope toy. All right, stay, Lily. All right, and let's rinse out. There we go. Look at all that dirt you have between your paws. Oh my goodness, you're such a silly girl. All right, and does that cover pretty much everybody? Pine, I don't know if you got up to anything. He's so ready to go see his mate again. Don't worry, we'll go get Devin. We'll go get Devin soon. Oh, come back here. Pine, hold still. P- Pine, hold still. All right. Yep, he didn't get anything because he's just been here the whole time. Pine, if you didn't miss your mate so much, then I would take you on the special walk. But I think that you're ready to have Devin come back, aren't you? Actually, Pine, I think I'll take you to the doggy daycare. Because I think just like one more week or so, and then your puppies are going to be ready to come with me on adventures. I just sense it. They're about old enough and they should be well trained after Erica has had them for so long. Ash, now are you having fun bathing? Oh, gracious. Zoe, I already washed you. All right, Tate, come here. All right, watch out, guys. Watch out. We're almost done with baths. All right, Tate, scrub you down. Scrub up. Tate, come back. Tate, come back. Tate, give. Tate, you have so much stuff. What are you doing with all these berries? Oh, my goodness. I don't even know how you got all of these. So Tate's been very busy, too. It's always so much fun. You never know what you're going to find when you search inside of the puppies' inventories after they've been walking around with you for a week. All right, there we go. Thank you, Tate. And you even have a little sign, too. Thank you, buddy. All right. So now let's put this away. Who to leave behind and who to take to the daycare this week? Well, I think Devin is probably going to actually go on another walk this week because she has all of the puppies and it's really good for the puppies to watch their mom walk around and then watch their dad walk around. So I think it's going to be Pine again and Devin. So Pine and Devin, and then we'll make sure we take the rest of the dogs on kind of a rotating basis out on walks because they deserve to stretch their paws and really start wandering around. But Ash, you, I want to stay here. You and the puppy, actually. I think I'm going to leave you guys here this time because you're a little nervous. And if you stay home, I think you'll feel a little bit better. So you can stay home, okay? And get used to what it's like to have your puppy with you. Zoe, you're really, really, really good with puppies. You're very good with young dogs. Can you please tell Ash, like, what it is to take care of little ones? Iris, you're really good, too. I think Zoe and Iris will be really good at helping... Yep. Okay. Stay here. And then Tate, you stay here too. I think Zoe and Iris will be really good at helping Ash feel better about his newfound role as a father. I don't think he knew when he wandered into the catacombs and dug up that doggy grave that he was actually going to be getting a son. So, all right, Relic. Look at all these little things. These medallions are so cool. I think the archaeologists at Relic Ruins are going to be thrilled to be able to look at these. All right. And Pine, come here, puppy. All right. We'll go ahead and we'll take Pine. And I think he's going to be so happy to see his mate again. I know, right, buddy? All right. So, good. These puppies are having a good time. It looks like I'm going to put Ash over here. Come on, Ash. Come on. You need to get used to being around Ash. Come, Ash. Oh, my gosh. Come. There we go. You just need to get used to being around your son. All right. There wasn't really anything jaw-dropping that the dogs managed to catch this time around, though I do appreciate all of the pineapple that somebody picked up because that'll make some really good salads, some nice delicious fruit salad or some pineapple juice. And Pine, I'm going to go ahead. Oh, that's right. I got to check the dog food. Looks like the dog food is still in good working order. All right. Good. Plenty of dog food. Wow. You guys are doing great. I'm not sure if I need to go get more dog food from the doggy daycare. Oh, well, maybe for this one at least. All right, I'll go get some more dog food for this dog food bowl. You just never know. The dogs will actually eat different amounts of dog food from the different food bowls through the week, and you just never know which one they're going to focus on. So that's kind of fun to see. All right, let's stop and take a watermelon breeze. Drink one of these because, man, they're refreshing. Not to mention now I smell like wet dog, and that's just not a scent you really want to have. All right, so, you know, before we head over to the daycare, I kind of want to go check in on the dryad, because she should be awake by now. Maybe the kind of call her a tree nymph. All right, and then Pine, come on, boy. Come on. All right, good boy. We're going to go see your mate. Come on. All right, your mate and your puppies. I bet he's going to be very happy. But we'll go check in on the tree nymph first, because I'm really... darling... Do you recognize these? You're a historian. Yeah, they're not exactly on. Okay. I know. You're a Chinese historian, and these are very clearly in English and not Chinese. But still, all right. Little Quill, stay here. Oh, thank you, Agent Noodles. A little bit of grass. Thank you. All right. I know Pine. We'll go see Devin in a second. Just I'm curious about these relic pieces. And Pine, Oh, there you are, Bubby. And not to mention, I'm also very curious about the tree nymph, because she's apparently from where the Great Phoenix is, and she's also from where Holly is. Remember Holly, your sister? Oh, gosh. Oh, goodness. And there's a dandelion. Thank you. Thank you, itty-bitty little hedgehog. Oh, gosh. He's so cute. Apparently, he's getting along really well with the little quill. But Holly, apparently, she has something to do with the Great Phoenix now, and the tree nymph, she fell asleep in my tree pine, but she's the one who brought back little puppy Relic from the dead, and she said something about elemental wolves and the hunter. Don't panic. It's gonna be okay. I'm sure your puppies are fine. Okay. Let's go check on her, and then we'll go check on your puppies. I know that you're probably nervous. I should have talked about, like, the hunter hunting down wolves. I don't know, like, elemental wolves? I don't know if I've ever seen an elemental wolf. I wonder what that looks like. I wonder what she meant. But let's see if she's awake yet. She's been asleep for a couple weeks, but I don't know. Hello? Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! Look at all the little things! There's a tiny little dragonfly and finches and butterflies! Oh, I'm so excited about this! Okay, wow, I didn't think about that, but I guess if you're a forest dryad, then you would attract the little animals. They're so precious and cute. Are you awake? Despite her human appearance, she is utterly still and as unresponsive as the tree itself. It seems as though it will be some time before she wakes up. Okay, so not awake yet, but that was very rude to sigh in someone's face when they're trying to sleep like that. But I don't know, all of those little animals clustered around her. I would think that she's probably going to wake up pretty soon. Maybe next time it's time to bathe the dogs, huh? It seems she's very attuned to their cycles. Alright, so let's go ahead and climb on up here. Alright, Pine. Come on, buddy. Let's go check on your puppies. I really, 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 really shouldn't have mentioned the hunter. That was very rude of me. I mean, how is a devoted dad like Pine not going to worry if you're talking about a wolf hunter next to his puppies? Alright, so let's go. Onward to the doggy daycare. You coming, Pine? Come on, buddy. I know you'll follow me. Come on. And we'll go check on your puppies and see how they're doing. And I do have a lot of coins, too. I don't even remember where the heck I got all these coins from. So I'm starting to get a little bit rich. Maybe I need to think about investing in some sort of safe. Oh, goodness. Pine, apparently you have inspired the villagers to drop things. Which one? Where? Where have you? Whose generosity is now on the ground to be collected? To be collected and made into my own. Alright, let's see. Somebody out here? Pine, just who the heck did you... did you convince to drop... maybe he collected the items. Who knows? Alright. Oh, here we go. Oh, it was you, Darren. I should have known. You always get so excited when you see the dogs. Thank you for the iron. That's pretty awesome. Alright, come on, Pine. Let's go see your puppies. I'm sure they're fine. I'm sure nothing has happened over here and that they're just totally okay and we don't... What? Okay. Well, I see Alia, so what's going on over here? Are those construction cones? What's happening at the doggy daycare? What's this? All right, well, let's come on in and see what's going on. All right, come on, Pine. Come on, here, we'll show you. Oh, what's this? Pardon our dust. Expansions underway. James, what's going on here? Oh, what? Signs? Help wanted, puppy keeper. Help wanted, dog food chef. Oh, are you getting another dog food chef, James? Like, okay, and then let's see. If you want to leave a dog in our daycare, you can talk to my sister in the backyard. All right, looks like you're just focused on cooking the dog food as usual. I do need to pick up a couple stacks of that in just a second. Oh, look at this, wonderful. So he's finally upgraded the bulk trade like I begged him to for so many times. So now I can come over and I can just straight up trade emeralds for stacks of food. Let's see, ostrich carrot and sweet potato mash, venison apple and spinach. Looks like the same types as he's always selling. But James, didn't you tell me you really desperately needed help with some new ideas for dog food flavors and types of dog food that you could sell? So, I definitely need some ideas on more flavors that James could sell that I could tell him, because clearly he needs some help with the dog food chef. I wonder if somebody who provides enough ideas or a really inspirational idea might somehow appear in our world as your helper, James. I think that would happen. All right, well, that said, All right, so what flavors is he selling again? Just in case anybody happens to come up with some really awesome dog food ideas that maybe an assistant could perhaps start making and selling. And something tells me that some snacks, like some lighter treats, are definitely needed for the puppies. So we already have pig's ear and beef liver for snacks for the dogs, but I imagine that there's all sorts of other kinds of yummy snacks they would enjoy too. Then we've got chicken, rice, and blueberry, duck, sweet potato, and cranberry, pork, rice, and carrot, pork and sweet pea, beef and liver, salmon, rice, and apple, venison, apple, and spinach, ostrich, carrot, and sweet mash. Those sound amazing if you're a dog, I guess. Oh, all right, Pine, all right. Well, check in on your puppies. I mean, what on earth is going on over here? All right, come here, boy. Come here. All right, Pine. Pine. Oh my gosh. All right, let me go grab Pine. I think he wants to be back with his mate and his puppies. All right, come here, boy. Come here. I know. You really want to see how everybody's doing. Let me close the door so we don't have any escaping puppies. Pardon our dust. Expansion's underway. Look at this. I mean, look. Oh, sorry, buddy. Right, there you go. Oh my gosh. Look at how big your babies are getting. Aspen, look at the size of you. Rex, Lassie, Ginger, Copper, Fern. Oh my gosh. They've gotten so big, Pine. Oh, he looks so proud. He looks so proud and so happy. And Devin looks so proud. Oh, the little family is back together. They do love it when they're all together. Oh, look at this. Oh my gosh, Alia, hey, baby! Oh my goodness, and there's like the big construction cones everywhere. Okay, what is this? What's this all about? Erica, what's happening here? Oh, Seri, I'm so glad to see you. You wouldn't believe what has happened. Our contractor has run out on us right in the middle of getting our doggy daycare expansion built. What are we going to do? It's all I can do to keep the puppies out of the crates. How will we get the expansion built too? Not to mention, we're running out of time. I promised the Pass the Paws group that we'd be ready soon for the new rescue dogs to arrive. Whoa, hang on, Erica. Wait, okay, all right. So your contractor's gone. Pass the Paws? I swear, that rings a bell. Something about Twin Bark Town. Something about that was the group that they had the animals go through to find new homes and new adoption centers. Pass the Paws just sounds really familiar. I haven't heard of them for about a year now. Anyway, all right. But okay, Erica, you're expanding the daycare? Oh, yes. I suppose I hadn't had a chance to tell you since you dropped off Alia and Devin last time. Well, my brother and I have decided to expand the doggy daycare. Since James won the award for the gourmet dog food competition, we've been getting so many orders for his dog food. I'm so proud of him, and the extra funds means we can finally expand the daycare like we've always dreamed of. Now we can make it into a place for rescue dogs too. Oh my gosh. So James won? I mean, my dogs have always loved his food, so I could see him winning a competition. I didn't know there was a gourmet dog food competition, but rescue dogs? Yes, rescue dogs. I mean, who doesn't want to help rescue lonely puppies in need of homes? It has been a dream of ours for so long, but until now, we've just been a small doggy daycare and dog food shop. But now we can expand and start providing housing for dogs who are waiting to be adopted. Or at least, we would be able to do that if our contractor hadn't run off on us. Can you believe it, Seri? What kind of contractor takes on a job at a doggy daycare and then runs off halfway into the job because they're allergic to dogs? What will I do now? Well, I would like to tell you that maybe, well, okay, yeah, all right, look, I know construction companies in Zoodesia are what they are, so I'll help, Erica. You mean it? You can help? Oh, Seri, that'd be so wonderful. I can't tell you what a huge burden that would take off James and I. Not to mention, I can watch your puppies for you while you work here. Free of charge, I promise. Plus, once we get the expansion built, we will be able to house dogs in need of adoption so that we can help out the homeless puppies of the world. Wouldn't that be amazing? Oh, and we even have plans for expanding the kitchen to offer more foods, and for building a puppy training yard, maybe even one day hosting dog shows. You don't mind helping out with all of the building then, do you, Seri? Oh, thanks so much, Seri! Oh, Okay, Erica. All right. Well, you know, it sounded like one thing. I thought we were just going to expand the fence area and provide more room for the dogs to roam in the yard, because that's what it looked like at first. And now you're, okay, well, I guess that's what those cones over there are for, expanding the kitchen and a dog show. I mean, I guess dog shows would be really amazing to host. Not to mention, they would be so much fun to do with all of the other zookeepers. Oh, my goodness. And then not to mention, it would be so much fun to be able to have an area where we could adopt out the dogs that we find in the wild. If not to the other people on the server, then maybe even to everybody else. Maybe our community could adopt some of these dogs. That would be fantastic! Okay, well, deep breaths. I could see why Erica is getting so excited, but I didn't exactly anticipate being in charge of this project, but I guess that's okay. I guess we can come over and, you know what, Erica? I won't be able to do it all the time because there's so much work to do in the zoo, but whenever I have some free time when I'm taking care of my dogs and it's like time to bathe everybody and bring them by for walks, then I will definitely work on expanding this too. So that should be a lot of fun. And I mean, until the forest nymph wakes up, I don't really have a lot I can do with her. I am almost tempted to go visit Holly myself at this rate, but not to mention Relic and all of his mysterious coins and his history. My dogs are definitely keeping me busy. And speaking of that, I should probably go ahead and check. Not like I have any room for this, but I should go ahead and check and see what my puppies have found from the puppy. Oh my goodness. From their special walk this week. I don't have any room for this. This is just, oh my gosh. Erica, is there maybe, oh, there's a crate over there. I wonder, all right. I'll be right back, Erica. Hang on just a second. Oh, maybe I could even, okay. I'm just going to sneak a few of these things. You don't mind, do you, James? And maybe you could consider it ingredients for some of the dog food that you're working on making. Oh, good. I did have some venison apple and sweet potato on me. All right. I'll keep the bright green ground cover. There we go. Yeah. Don't mind me, James. I'm just, you know what? I'll either come back for this or you could use it, sir. Okay, give me just a second. So it looks like, look at these. Oh, they're kind of cute, actually. I like them. Little construction cones. And then over here, all right, what's this? Is this a little, ooh, a carpentry bench. What does it do? What? What? Little guns? Banners? What on earth? I've never seen these before. Holy, is this how you make this? Is this how you make these things? Oh my gosh. This is how you make the crates. I had no idea. I've just been buying from the Cooper and Relic Ruins this whole time. And weapon racks. Oh my goodness. Look at all of this. This is how you make these. I didn't know that actually. I didn't know this is how you make the barrels either. So if that's how you make the barrels, then how do you make the crates? Like, do you just make them? And then, oh, so I guess the barrels are just skinnier versions of, yeah, oh my gosh, that's so cool. I had no idea that's how that worked. Well, I'm very excited about that and can't open these crates, but, oh, and then what's this? Carpenter's blocks, coffee stained plans. I guess this should help me figure out what was planned for the expansion of the doggy daycare, but, okay, let's see. And then utter gibberish. Cup of coffee, coffee stained plans that I can't even read because they are covered in coffee stains. All right, so it looks like I have no idea what the contractor had in mind for expanding this area, but I'm sure that I'll get plenty of great suggestions, don't you worry, Alia, on things that we would be able to add into this area as a fantastic, absolutely beautiful doggy daycare playpen. So we definitely need lots and lots and lots of ideas of what we could add in for the doggy daycare all over the place. Maybe fountain. Ooh, maybe a little waterfall. As long as the puppies don't drown in the waterfall, we'll have to definitely make sure it's a dog safe waterfall. Maybe some little ramps or like an agility course, or maybe some like little cylinders that they can run through. Oh, those all sound like great ideas. I definitely need more ideas for what we could do over here though. So, ideas for the dog food, ideas for what we could put in for the puppy play area expansion. Oh my gosh. And ideas for, I guess if Erica is going to run like an adoption center, ideas for what it should look like if we do have a dog adoption center. Maybe we should have like a little dog house for each of the dogs that are available for adoption that have like their items and a little book with facts about them inside of it. Oh, that would be really fun because we're always finding stray German shepherds and poodles and pugs all over the world. And then we would have somewhere to bring them so they could hopefully find a new home. Oh, I really love that idea. So I'll try to help out, Erica. Like I said, every time I come and bring my dogs to go on a walk, you know, every Sunday or so, then I'll come and I'll work on this as long as the forest nymph doesn't have some other ideas for me and I don't need to take this in. Okay, basically there's a lot to do, Erica, but I will do my best to help build you like this area and build the expansion to the kitchen and build, I guess, the dog show area. Where am I even gonna put a dog show area, Alia? I'll do my best to do all of that for you when I have the free time. All right, so speaking of that though, oh, I should get out my money. No, she said she'd watch my puppies, but I mean, if it's gonna be for a good cause, because she's going to try to make some room for adoptions, then I'll go ahead and pay for another special dog walk so that we can send our puppies on a special dog walk again. So Devin, you're gonna go on another walk. Pine, you're gonna go ahead and you are gonna go on another walk with Devin. So you guys can either go to the same place or go to different places depending on what people vote in the video description for the straw poll on where you guys should go walk. So be sure to pick out where Devin and Pine are gonna go on their special walk in the straw poll in the video description, you guys. And Alia, you're gonna come home with me. So let's see what you collected, Alia, because this is the dog walk discovery box. Every time we have a dog quest, we're able to put our dogs out for a special walk with Erica, who's currently playing with all of the puppies. Look at all of that. Oh, that's so cute. And then we can come back and we can see what they found. So Devin, I was told that you went on a special walk to the park with your puppies last time, and Alia, you followed a weird scent. That always concerns me. Last time someone followed a weird scent, it was Ash, and he brought home a puppy of his own. So are you trying to do what your brother did? All right, let's check this out. All right, so special walk for Devin, and it looks like she has found, okay, we got to remove these. These are our old special walk tickets, so we'll put in the new ones. So it looks like Devin found at the park a dog collar, a dog biscuit, another dog biscuit, some bread, a twig, a key. Devin, what does this unlock? Devin, I have so many special items now. I don't even know what to do with all of them. Oh my goodness. So Devin found a key. I have no idea what that's going to unlock, and what? A golf club? Oh my gosh, can I really whack a zombie over the head with a golf club? I've never had a golf club before. This is amazing. We'll have a good time with that. Devin, okay, so it looks like you raided somebody who was playing golf. And empty nest, twig, dog collar, empty nest. Another empty nest. You like definitely were digging around with some birds, weren't you, Devin? All right. Plastic cup, a wooden fishing rod, pecan pie, plastic bag, and pecan pie. So it looks like she raided somebody's, definitely looks like she raided somebody's picnic, but then she also must have met with some other dogs who lost their collars. Yeah, there's some dog biscuits here. And then somebody, probably somebody who likes to relax by fishing and golfing. And maybe that's the key to their stuff? I don't know. We'll have to see what that's all about. So that's what Devin found on her special walk this week. I definitely want to try whacking a zombie with the golf club. That seems kind of amazing. Oh, and the key. So now I've got the key and the relic, and I need to help expand the doggy daycare, and the forest dryad is going to wake up any day, and then we'll be able to start helping her out with the elemental wolves that she keeps hinting about. Oh my goodness. And then here is the special walk that Alia went on. So it looks like she found a poison potato. I should really teach my dogs not to sniff this. I wonder if actually Erica could start teaching my dogs special lessons to look for specific items, or maybe to avoid certain items if we're getting like too many dangerous things like poisonous potatoes. I could probably work that. And then incense cone that inspires you to jump. Oh, a heart. Like a beating heart made of fire. That's a little concerning, but it'll be great for when we try to breed unicorns in our farming site series. I'm just, oh, that's so creepy. Oh, I wonder if that's gonna make the flame penguins happy. Oh, tell me the flame penguins don't eat that. I don't need heart, flame heart eating bloody vampire penguins in my basement, and yet there they are. Oh, and there's a burning blossom. That'll make the vampire penguins happy. I guess I have to take care of them for a little while till I find a new home for them, since they are in my basement and I'm in charge of them. Some slime, kelp, pine sap, fried chicken, baked ham, garlic chicken, a squid. Alia, you are just as unique as your brother, my dear. Oh my goodness, what am I gonna do with all this stuff? I don't even know what I'm gonna do with all this stuff. Industrial fertilizer. Is that a fancy way to say poop? So I think that's a fancy way to say poop. Then there's a poisonous potato, slime ball, smells like old socks cheese. Ew. I'm gonna, can I feed that to like one of the goats in Zomberry Village? Maybe I'll do that. cookie with odd purple dots. I have learned my lesson about eating odd cookies. Industrial fertilizer and some peppermint, which I don't know if after finding it next to the industrial fertilizer, I would want to eat that peppermint. But there we go. Wow, look at all this random stuff the puppies found on their special walk. All right, so that's quite interesting. And Erica, like I said, I will do my best when I come and bring back my puppies. All right, come on, Alia. You're going to go ahead and you're going to follow me home. But I will do my best when I bring back my puppies every week to be able to expand your area. So if I have some free time, I'll pop by and work on that here too. Pine, I'm glad you're back with Ginger, Lassie, Copper, Rex, Aspen, Fern, and Devin, of course. So you stay here with your puppies. And now we need to make sure we vote on Pine's special walk and Devin's special walk. And we'll have to see what the key Devin found this week is going to unlock. We'll have to figure out what Relic and his mysterious history is all about. Whew, and there's just so much more to do in this zoo too. Oh, all right. So my puppies are taken care of. The doggy daycare is expanding and we'll help out with that. The forest dryad needs help. There's basically a lot to do and so many adventures to go on. So I'll see you guys next time.